Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about one of the major important activity or mouse action called as drag and drop. So in the previous videos, I already talked about mouse over, how to perform double click and right click. So let's focus on drag and drop in this video. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to show you, I'm going to use a website. Let me just open this in the Chrome browser. Right, so this is my website. So here, let me just open one more time. I think .html. Right. So in this website, so I have few elements here. These are all different capitals, and other side I can see different kinds of countries. Okay. Now here we have to move these capitals into required countries here. So for example, here I want to move this Rome like this to Italy. Okay, this is a basically we can do using mouse drag and drop action. So the same action how we can perform by using Selenium code. Now let us see that. So let me just go to PyCharm again. Now here I'm creating a new Python file. So I'll name it as drag and drop. Now okay. Now first thing, we need to import the web driver from Selenium. So from Selenium, import web driver, and then all kinds of mouse related activities we can do by using actions chains object, right? So we need to also import action chains class. So from selenium.webdriver we have to import action chains class. Now let's create a driver. So driver is equal to web driver dot, I'm using Chrome as a driver, so I'll just say driver.chrome, and also we need to specify the location where my Chrome driver is present. So executable path, we need to specify the executable path is equal to, and here we need to specify the location where my driver is present. Let me just copy the location here. So this is the location where my driver is present. Now I need to open the URL of application. So driver.get, and here specify the URL of the application. This is your URL. Let's copy this and specify here. Now this URL will be opened on the browser. So as soon as the URL is opened on the browser, I want to maximize this window. So otherwise what happens is it will open a small window like this. You cannot see all the elements sometime. So what I can do is I will maximize the window as soon as I open the URL. Now how we can do this? driver.maximize window. So this will maximize your browser. And now this is the main activity we need to do now. So before moving this element one place to another place, we need to identify two things here. One is what is the source element and what is the target element. So from where to where we need to move the source element and target element. So these two we need to first identify, and then we can easily do drag and drop. So here let us say I want to move this Rome to the Italy. Okay, so Rome is a source element and Italy is my target element. Now we need to identify these two elements. Now let's identify this Rome, inspect this Rome element and get that XPath for this. ID is available. We can use ID or we can also get the XPath for this. Let me capture XPath for this Rome. Now identify this element. driver.findElementById.XPath. Now specify that XPath here. This is a single quotation. Alright, so now this will able to identify the element. As soon as it has identified the element, we can store that into a variable. Let me just call it as a source_element. This is your source_element. Now similarly, we need to also identify the target element. So here Italy is my target element. Now inspect this Italy. Now here get the text path for this. Now go to code here. Let's identify again the second element, target element. So driver.findElementById.XPath, and in the double quotation specify your XPath of the element. Now store this target element in a variable. My variable name is target underscore element. So now we have identified source element and target element. Now what's the next thing we need to do? We have to just drag the source element to target element. So to do this, we have to create an object for action scene class. Now object name is actions is equal to action chains, and here we need to pass driver as a parameter. Action scene class object we create. Now by using this actions object, we can use a method called drag and drop. A direct method is available. So here actions dot drag and drop. This is a command or method, drag and drop. So this will take two parameters, source and target. What is the source and what is the target? So those two elements we need to pass here. So source element we already here, so we have just pass it comma, and target element and pass it here. So now what happens is this source element will move to the target element. It will drag and drop into the target element. And if you want to complete this action, we need to use dot a perform keyword. Okay, now this action will be completed. So this statement will perform a drag and a drop action. Now let us run this code and see. Run as drag and drop. Now we can observe here, first it opens the window, now it will maximize this. Now it should move Rome into Italy. Now it is moved. Alright, now we can see here, it is moved from Rome. So here to here, target is Italy, right? So this is how we can do the drag and drop actions by using action chains object. And what is the method we have to use here? Drag and drop method. And we need to pass source element and the target element. So anywhere if you found this kind of scenarios, we can just use this particular method to drag the element from the source element to target element. Alright, so with this we have done all the mouse related actions. Mouse over we have seen in the previous videos, double click, right click, and now we already seen about drag and drop. That's all for this video. So thanks for watching this. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.